Hello guys, so in the last video we discussed about dimension application and its limitation. So in today's video we are going to learn about errors in a measurement, and we discuss various types of error and the method by which we can resolve the error. So watch the complete video, share it with your friends and subscribe the channel. So in the measurement, the first topic is significant figures. So significant figures are those digits which are reliable in the measurement of any physical quantity. So when we measure any physical quantity during an experiment or in some calculation, then the digits which are reliable for its measurement is called significant digits. Significant digits are identified on the basis of certain rules, in which the first rule is that all the non-zero number in the expression of measurement are considered as significant. So in this measurement there are three significant digits. In the rule number two, if there is a zero lies between the non-zero number, then the zero is also significant. So there are four significant digits. In rule number three, if a zero lies in the left hand side of non-zero number, then it is not significant, and then there's only three significant digits. According to rule number four, if a zero lies on the right hand side of a non-zero number, then again it is not significant, then there's only three significant digits. But in the same concept, if the zero on the right of non-zero number express any measurement, then the zero is countable, then there are four significant figures. In the next rule, if there is a zero before the decimal point, then again the zero is countable and there are four significant digits. So in the expression of without measurement and without decimal point, the zero is non-significant, otherwise the zero is significant. Then in the next rule, if there is a zero on the left and right side of the decimal point, but they lie before the non-zero digits, then these zero are not significant and only two significant digits are given. Similarly, if there are zero lies on the right hand side of non-zero number in decimal expression, then these zero are countable and we have to write four significant digits. In the next rule, if we change the unit of the expression, then there will be no change in the significant digits. So there is only one significant digit, and then there is again only one significant digit. In the next rule, if a measurement has the expression in which there is an exponential power of 10, then these power are not considered as significant and we have to write only two significant digits. So according to these rule, we can find the number of significant digit in any expression. Now let's learn some rule to round off a measurement in which a certain expression mentioned in a certain decimal digits. That rule works on the rule of 5, in which the first rule is, if the digit which we want to draw is more than 5, then the preceding digit is increased by 1. So if you want to write the expression in only two decimal point and we have to drop 6, 6 is more than 5, so the preceding digit increased by 1 and we have to write 0.68. In the second rule, if we want to drop a digit which is less than 5, then the preceding digit is remain same. So if you want to drop 3 which is less than 5, so 7 remains 7 and this is 2.67. In the rule number 3, if we want to drop a digit that is 5 and it is followed by a non-zero number, In that case, it treated as it is more than 5 and the preceding digit is increased by 1. To simplify that rule, let's understand, if you want to drop a single digit, then apply the rule of 5. And if you want to drop two digits simultaneously, then apply the rule of 50, less than 50 or more than 50. And for three digits, you can apply the rule of 500 and so on. And in the next case, if you want to drop a digit which is just 5, then you have to check the preceding digit is even or odd. If the digit is odd, then it is increased by 1. And if the digit is even, then it will remain same. So in the decimal number, if you want to drop just 5, then the preceding digit is even, then it remains same, and if it is odd, it increases by 1. So these are the 5 rules according to which you can round off an expression according to the desired value. In certain question, we have to use the measurement of more than one physical quantity. In that case, we have to apply certain operations like addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, etc. on the measurement. So there are certain rules to identify the proper significant figures or to write the answer in appropriate manner. So let's find how we identify the significant figure during the sum or difference between two or more measurements. So when we are adding or subtracting two or more expression, then the result will have the same decimal point as the original number with the minimum decimal point. For example, if we add 2.50 with 0.2, then in these two expressions, this term have two decimal point and this term have only one decimal point. Then their addition is 2.70 is also have only one decimal point because it is minimum. So we write only 2.7 in the answer. So in the addition or difference, we have to focus on the original number which having only minimum number of decimal point, because the same number of decimal point we have to mention in the answer of the result. Now, if we have to identify the significant digits in the product or division of two or more expression, then we have to apply the rule of minimum significant digits. So when we are multiplying or dividing two or more expression, then the result will have the same significant digit as the original number with the minimum significant digits. So in addition and subtraction, we have the rule of minimum decimal point, but in multiplication and division, we have the rule of minimum significant digits. For example, if we multiply 0.25 with 0.2 into 1.00, then in that case, this number have two significant digits. This one have only one significant digit, and this number have three significant digits. So their product, which is 0.05, have only one significant digit because this is the least significant digit number in the original number. So our answer is 0.05, that will have only one significant digit. So we do not have to change the expression. So always remember the rule of least decimal place for addition and subtraction and least significant figure for product and division. So to measure any physical quantity, we use certain methods and operators, and during the measurement, there are some types of error which occur, which may be manually or systematically. which differ the measured value of physical quantity to the true value. So the difference between the true value and the measured value of a physical quantity is considered as error. So error is basically the difference between true value and measured value of any physical quantity, and this error can be positive or negative depending that measured value is more than or less than the true value. So if we find the cause of that error, we can minimize it, and there are number of causes which are responsible for the error in measurement. Let's discuss the various types of error which occur during the measurement. So we have five types of error which we experience during the measurement of any physical quantity. The first one is constant error. So constant errors are those errors which occurred in a fixed value due to the faulty calibration of the apparatus. And these errors can easily be eliminated by using different apparatus or technique. The second type of error which we face is systematic error. So systematic error is the error which occurred due to the system. And by finding the cause of that error, we can remove that error. So during the measurement of physical quantity, the system consists of four categories. So first is the instrument, second is the observer which conducting the experiment, third is the external condition, and fourth is the technique used to conduct the experiment. And in these four parameters, any of them can cause the error. So the first type of systematic error is instrumental error. So instrumental error is the error caused due to instrument we use for experiment. For example, zero error is an instrumental error in which we get reading without any measurement. So these errors can be removed by repairing the device or replacing the device. The second type of systematic error is imperfection in technique. So if we are conducting the experiment with imperfect technique, then we again get some error. So we can rectify that condition by using a proper technique to conducting the experiment. The third type of systematic error we have is the personal error. So this is the error occurred due to the observer or the individual which conducting the experiment. And this error can be removed if that experiment conduct with carefulness or another person conduct that experiment in a better manner. The fourth type of systematic error is external cause. So sometime due to wind, pressure, temperature or any other external cause, we get some error in the measurement. That error can be minimized by controlling the external condition, which is easily possible in today's scenario. So third category of the error are random errors. So random errors are those errors which can occur in any direction due to random causes. So their causes are unknown, so we cannot remove this error completely, but we can minimize random errors. To minimize them, we have to take a number of reading and then we find the arithmetic mean of those readings, and that arithmetic mean is considered as approximate true value. The fourth type of error we have, the least count error. This is again the part of a system or the instrument, because every instrument which we use for the measurement have a certain least count below which it cannot measure the physical quantity. Like in meter scale, it has the least count of 0.1 centimeter. Below 0.1 centimeter, it is not able to measure the length. Then we prefer vernier caliper which have the least count of 0.01 centimeter. So if we want to minimize the least count error, we have to prefer a device which have the lower least count value, because deeper is the value, more correct is the answer. The last type of error is gross error. So this type of error is occurred due to the carelessness of observer or the person conducting the experiment, and there is no technique to minimize those errors until the observer conduct the experiment carefully. So these are some cause of error which occur during the measurement. Now let's find how can we calculate the amount of error occurred during the expression. So before calculating various types of error, let's take an example in which A physical quantity is measured and we have a various number of reading for its measurement. Then the true value of the physical quantity can be obtained by taking the arithmetic mean of all the readings. So this can be considered as a true value of the physical quantity. Now the first type of error we have to find is absolute error. So absolute error is basically the difference between true value and each reading of the physical quantity. So it is represented by delta A. Then delta A1 is the error in first reading, that is A minus A1, it may be positive or negative. And similarly, delta A2, the absolute error in second reading. Then similarly, delta AN is the absolute error in last reading. So absolute error can be positive or negative depending on the difference between true value and measured value. The second type of error which we can calculate is mean absolute error. So mean absolute error represented by mod delta A, and it is basically the arithmetic mean of all the absolute error with their modulus, because the absolute errors can be positive or negative, and to find the arithmetic mean we have to apply modulus on them. So true value is the arithmetic mean or average of reading, and mean absolute error is the average or arithmetic mean of absolute error. So the physical quantity which we are going to measure can be expressed as A plus minus delta A. So this is the true value and this is the mean absolute error in the total measurement of the physical quantity. Now the third type of error which we can obtain is relative error, which is also known as fractional error. So it is the ratio of mean absolute error and the true value, or you can say it is the ratio of sum of absolute error with the sum of readings. And the fourth type of error we have is the percentage error, which we can obtain by multiplying relative error with 100. So that's how we can obtain the percentage error in the measurement of a physical quantity during an experiment. So by using different formula, we can find different type of error which asked to us. As we discussed the various types of error that occur in the measurement of a physical quantity, but then there are some physical quantity which cannot be measured directly, and we have to use two or more than two physical quantity to obtain that quantity. So we have to find the error during the combination of more than one physical quantity. So let's find the error in the combination, in which we first discuss the error in addition, for which let two physical quantity which are in the form of their true value and error. So A is A plus minus delta A and B is B plus minus delta B. And let we have to find their addition or sum S, which is A plus B. Then the sum is also in the form of true value and error. So we have to find the true value and the error of the sum. To find that, let put the value of A and B. So S is equal to A plus minus delta A, and B is B plus minus delta B. So true value is added with true value and error is added with error. So in that expression, this is the true value of addition and this is the error in addition. So in the addition of two physical quantity, true value added with true value to give ट्रू वैल्यू ऑफ एडिशन एंड एरर इज एडिड विद एरर टू प्रोवाइड द फाइनल एरर. इन द सेम वे वी कैन फाइंड द एरर इन सब्ट्रैक्शन. नाउ लेट्स फाइंड द एरर इन डिफरेंस. सो वी हैव टू फिजिकल क्वांटिटी ए एंड बी एंड द डिफरेंस ऑफ देम इज ए माइनस बी इज ऑल्सो एक्सप्रेस इन फॉर्म ऑफ इट्स ट्रू वैल्यू एंड द एरर विच वी आर गोइंग टू फाइंड. फॉर दैट वी पुट द वैल्यू ऑफ ए एंड बी एंड गेट ए प्लस माइनस डेल्टा ए माइनस बी प्लस माइनस डेल्टा बी. सो ए माइनस बी प्लस माइनस डेल्टा ए माइनस प्लस डेल्टा बी. सो इन द गिवन एक्सप्रेशन द एरर इन डी इज मैक्सिमम व्हेन दीज टू एरर हैव द सेम साइन देन इट कैन बी रिटन एज डेल्टा ए प्लस माइनस डेल्टा बी. सो इन डिफरेंस ए माइनस बी रिप्रेजेंट the true value and delta a plus delta b represent the error. So the true value is a minus b but the error is delta a plus delta b. So error is added in addition as well as in difference. It will not subtracted with each other. Only true value can subtract with each other. This rule of addition of error is applicable only for addition and subtraction. But in case of multiplication and division, we are not able to find the absolute error directly, but we can find a relative error. Now let's find the error in product of physical quantity. So we have two physical quantity whose product is A into B. Then the true value of product is P, which is AB, and the relative error in the product is the sum of relative error in A and relative error in B. And this expression is obtained by the following method, because when we put the value of A and B, which is A plus minus delta A, multiply with B plus minus delta B, then we get AB plus minus A delta B plus minus B delta A plus delta A delta B. Then in that expression, the term delta A delta B, A delta B and B delta A represent the error, and this term AB represent the true value. So the true value of product is AB and the error in product is A delta B plus B delta A plus delta A delta B. Then if we divide the true value with the error, we get delta P by P is equal to this divided by AB, that become delta B by B, that become delta A by A, and that become delta A delta B by AB. As we know, the error is very small quantity, and when a small quantity multiply with another small quantity, it become very small. And if we divide it with the true value, it become completely negligible as compared to those. So by neglecting that small term, we get the relative error is the sum of relative error in the given original physical quantity. So the relative error in product is the sum of relative error in the initial physical quantity, which are multiplying together to provide that quantity. Now let's find the expression of error when two quantity divided with each other. So when A and B are divided with each other, so their fraction f is A by B, then the true value fraction is the division of A with B, and the relative error in fraction is the sum of relative error in A and relative error in B, same as we proved in a product. Because the error in addition and subtraction is same, similarly the method to find the relative error in product and in division is also same. Now let's find the error in that physical quantity विच डिपेंड ऑन वेरियस क्वांटिटी विद देयर पर. सो इफ देयर इज अ फिजिकल क्वांटिटी जेड डिपेंड ऑन थ्री फिजिकल क्वांटिटी विद देयर रिस्पेक्टिव पर, देन द ट्रू वैल्यू इन जेड कैन बी ऑब्टेन बाय पुटिंग द ट्रू वैल्यू ऑफ ए बी एंड सी विद देयर पर, बट द रिलेटिव एरर इन जेड कैन बी ऑब्टेन बाय एडिंग द रिलेटिव एरर विद देयर respective power. So power into relative error of A plus power into relative error of B and power of C into relative error of C. That's how we can obtain the relative error in Z. And if we want to find the percentage error, we can multiply by 100 both of the side and we get percentage error in Z is equal to plus minus power into percentage of A plus power of B into percentage of B plus power of C into percentage of C. So the relative error and percentage error can be obtained by using the following formula. So in different cases, we can find any type of error by using these type of formulas.